Have you ever wondered how your favorite YouTuber or singer gets perfectly good quality audio, especially when they're using an external USB microphone and recording with their iPhone? Well, if you have, I'm gonna show you how you can record video with your iPhone, audio with a USB microphone, and how you can sync the two together to make a perfect video. So at the moment, we're recording the video with our DSLR, but now we're gonna switch to the iPhone. And as you can hear, we've also switched the audio to the iPhone's built-in microphone. And it sounds a bit tinny, a bit echoey, a bit distant, and this is what the sound comes like from the iPhone itself. And a lot of YouTubers start off this way because the iPhone is actually a pretty good camera for filming on, but the audio is where it lets it down. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna continue shooting with the iPhone. But now we've switched to the SL600 USB microphone. And as you can already hear, the audio quality is lovely and crisp. There's a nice level of bass and treble to the sound, and it's taken out a lot of the distant sounds and echoes that were in the room before. So we've done this in post. It's really easy to do. So I'm gonna show you a step-by-step guide on how you can do it too. So step one is to download Audacity. You can use any recording software, but Audacity is available for both Mac and PC, and it's free. Next, you need to plug in your SL600 to your Mac or PC, and then select that as the input device for your computer, as well as the recording software you're using, such as Audacity. Step three is a little bit of a tip. You wanna make sure your iPhone is on a tripod so it keeps the shot nice and steady. There's nothing worse than some shaky video footage. Step four, hit record on Audacity, then hit record on your camera so you're recording at the same time. So now we've got the audio being recorded on the SL600, as well as the video and audio of the iPhone being recorded directly to the iPhone itself. So the next thing you want to do is a big clap when you're recording. This will be recorded into your SL600 and the iPhone's video, and it allows you to sync up the audio and video a bit later on, so it's a really important step. So when you finish recording, make sure you press stop on your iPhone and stop in Audacity. Now, within Audacity, you can export as an MP3 or a WAV. A WAV file is a little bit higher quality, so I'd recommend doing that if you can. Okay, so next you'll need some basic video editing software. And for this example, we're using iMovie as it's free with a Mac. For a PC, you can use something called VideoPad, and we'll include the links below in the description. So I've already started a new project here in iMovie, and I've imported our video clip here and then our audio clip from Audacity. So I've dragged down the section of the clip into iMovie, and as you can hear, this is the audio and the video directly from the iPhone, which doesn't sound too great. So this is the video footage coming straight from the iPhone, and the audio is being recorded with the SL600. So as you can see here, the audio isn't that great. So what we want to do is bring down this audio file here from Audacity and sync it up. Now what will happen here when you drag it onto the timeline, it will of course be completely out of sync if we play that back now.
This is the video footage coming straight from the iPhone.
So you can hear that both audio files from the iPhone and Audacity are playing at the same time. So the first thing you want to do is right click here on your video clip and click detach audio. Then, because we actually want to get rid of the audio which was recorded on the iPhone and we want to replace that with our really good SL600 audio, all you do is simply click this and then hit the delete key. Now, the next thing we want to do is line up the audio perfectly so it's fully in sync. Now, this is why we did the clap at the beginning of the video clip, because here you can see in the actual audio waveform, you can see the clap peaking right there. So what we need to do is find a point in the video where you can see the clap happen, which is, if we take it back to the start, which is about there. And then what we do is if we drag the audio along to that point and get it all lined up, you should see that luckily this is kind of almost perfect already for us. But if we now play that back, you should see that the audio is perfectly now in time. Let's play it back and have a listen.
So this is the video footage coming straight from the iPhone, and the audio is being recorded with the SL600. The problem we have is that the iPhone's video and audio are linked. So there you have it.
Okay, so now I'm gonna show you how to sync the audio together using VideoPad on a PC or a Mac. I've imported the video footage here into VideoPad using the add file section here, and I've added the audio file from Audacity in here. So basically all you need to do is get your clip,
let's drag that into the video section there, and that will add that to the timeline. And you'll see here, you have the audio and the video from the iPhone if we play that through.
So this is the video footage coming straight from the iPhone, and the audio is being recorded with the SL600.
So you can see there that the audio is not particularly great. So what we're going to do next is get our Audacity audio file. We're going to click and drag that, and we're going to click in this little section here at the bottom to create a new mix. Now you can see that we have three layers. We have the video, we have the iPhone audio, and then we have our Audacity SL600 file. So what we want to do is sync these two files up. And this is why we did the clap at the start of the video. So this is why we did the clap at the start of the video file. And you can see here, as we drag this along, if you look at the start of the waveform here, just under the red cursor, that's where we made our clap. And then if you look at the iPhone's audio file here, you can also see that clap. So what we want to do is we want to move this and then sync them up. Luckily, the clips are almost the same length, so they sync up quite well. Now, if we play them together at the same time, you'll hear both the iPhone's audio and the SL600 audio being played at the same time. So we can do that here by clicking on the audio track one. We want to right-click that and then unlink from video. Once that's unlinked, you can just click onto the file, hit delete, or right-click and then delete. This will remove the iPhone's audio, and it will leave you with your clean, crispy SL600 audio, and it will now sound perfectly great.
So this is the video footage coming straight from the iPhone, and the audio is being recorded with the SL600. The problem we have is that
So there we have it. You now have some clean audio, some clean video, and you can now export this file so you can use it on your new YouTube channel.
So that's it. You've now got a great video with some great audio, which you can now upload to YouTube. So I hope you found this tutorial really helpful. And if you want more tips and tutorials, check out our Editor's Keys YouTube channel, and make sure you subscribe and hit that notification bell as well. I hope you found that really useful. Remember, you can contact us anytime for advice. We're on Twitter at Editor's Keys, Facebook at Editor's Keys, and also Instagram at Editor's Keys, so we're very easy to find. And if you're using our equipment, make sure to tag us in as well, as we love to see what you're up to with the equipment. So, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.